Hi. Oh, okay. I'm just gonna line us up. There's only like one person here at the moment. I'm a bit early, so hi. This is really weird, so I don't ever feel nervous about teaching, yet for some reason, because technology is involved and it could all go so wrong, that's why I feel a little bit nervous. But yeah, you're joining. So we'll get started in like 2 minutes. I would just like grab your mat, grab like blocks, blankets, all that jazz, and then we can get started. I'm really sorry initially, obviously, about the sound. Can you just like, can someone comment and be like, yeah, I can hear you? And then I might see it come up. Because last time, let me see what it's saying. As you can tell. Yeah, okay, I want to be able to see what you guys are saying. Apparently, I can't do that. Oh, yeah, I can hear you. Thank you. Yay, go team. Okay, so thank you guys. Yeah, so the sound isn't gonna be amazing because I don't have a swanky hookup with a microphone. It's just literally through my phone, but you know, it's a free yoga class, so we can't complain. Okay, 1 minute. Has anyone got any questions they want to ask me while I'm here? I feel like otherwise I'm just gonna sit and stare at the screen for like for a few minutes. Da, da, da. Cool, there's people coming from like all other countries. This is really cool. It's so nice to have like a community of people that, yeah, they're all like-minded. Oh, what kind of flow we'll be doing? I'm gonna keep it like an all levels vinyasa flow. So we're gonna work through some sun salutations. We're going to do just a little short bit of meditation to begin with. We're going to be doing some pranayama and then working through, yeah, just a nice creative fun flow. Simba is in the house in case any of you have seen him. Okay, go you. You can do crow pose. Simba is here, but he is like, hopefully he's sleeping at the moment, so hopefully he's going to stay sleeping. Okay, someone's like, Simba! Yeah, man, he's cool. Okay, I did put his bed next to the mat in case he decided that he wanted to come and like hang out with us. Right, oh, I'm gonna go and get myself together. He's seeing me move now. He wants in on the fun. Okay. Hey, buddy. It's okay. Oh, here he comes. Are you gonna say hi to your friend? No. He just turned away again. He was like, nah, this yoga is not for me. Hi. You're gonna be a good boy. You're gonna be a good boy. I don't think that's where you're gonna sit, is it? I did practice earlier and he just sat on my hands in a downward facing dog. Okay. You can go to bed. We're still working on that command. Simba, you come over here. Come to bed. Come on. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Nope, that didn't work. Anyway, if I ignore him, he'll usually do his own thing. Okay, so we're gonna get started. Sorry, you can just see Simba's bum at the moment. If you're just joining, I apologize. He will at some point just go and chill out when he realizes that he's not getting any attention. So, just coming down to your mat, we're gonna start with a little bit of meditation, just a little bit of grounding. So either popping yourself up on a block, grounding the sit bones down into either your block or the mat. And I want you to think about growing tall through the crown of the head. And then all the way down the spine, so coming down to the coccyx, the root of the spine, allowing that part to ground down into your block or your mat. So you get this kind of like pulling sensation, like the spine is just lengthening the whole way. Take a big shoulder roll back. Feel the shoulder blades travel down the spine. You're gonna take three big inhales and sigh everything out through the mouth. Inhale. 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 earth to its natural rhythm. Just observing what's going on. Maybe the breath is shallow, maybe it's deep. Just being aware. And it's quite hard to be aware of the breath without making changes. Really just try not to have any judgment on the breath right now. Let it be as it is. And notice if it's telling you about your mindset right now. Maybe it's telling you about the day you had. I'm just going to stay with some stillness for a little moment. Every time the mind wanders, just coming back to those inhales and the exhales. Mind now to set an intention for your practice. So what are you going to offer to your practice? Maybe the focus on the breath, the kindness to your body. Maybe you're doing your practice with someone next to you and you're just going to offer up your joy, your lightheartedness. Whatever it is, set that intention. Drop the chin down to the chest, just keeping the eyes closed. Taking half neck rolls, so right ear comes to right shoulder. Come down through center, left ear to left shoulder. Just working through, inhaling as you come to the side, exhaling as you come down through center. Notice any little niggles, any tightness in the neck, especially if you've maybe been at a desk all day, maybe pausing on any moments. Any sections that feel particularly tight and taking an extra breath there. And coming back to neutral, lifting up the head, taking the chin all the way up. Head goes back, opening through the throat. Again, notice any resistance here. This is one of those things that people feel like they don't want to be opening through the throat. It can feel a bit uncomfortable. It feels very vulnerable. Opening through that throat chakra. Coming all the way back to center. Inhale, sweep the arms all the way up. Exhale, hands come down through heart center. Inhale, open out to cactus, sweep the arms. Exhale, round the spine, let the head drop. Inhale, coming back to neutral. If you're up on a block, just pop your block to one side. Coming onto all fours, working through some cow and some cat. So we're going to inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, round the spine. Inhale, find that lift. Exhale, round. So tapping into that Ujjayi breath, if that's something that you practice with. If you're unsure what I'm talking about, you're like, Ujjayi what? That's absolutely fine. Just deep inhales and exhales through the nose. Will be absolutely perfect. From here, we're going to take the right leg out long. Holding here. And then bring that right leg around to the side. So I said vinyasa flow, but normally that means some kind of power. Feel that right glute really switch on. Right leg goes back out to the back. And then see if you can take the right arm off. So we're coming into a little modified, kind of like an Ardha Chandrasana, but down on the knee. Ooh. Trying to keep the balance, opening the hip
up, seeing if you can gaze up to the ceiling. And release right hand, release right knee, reset the posture. Okay, this time taking the left foot back. So holding here to begin with. And then you're gonna take that left leg, all the way out to the side. Really tapping into that left side glute now, but you're gonna notice that the right side's still firing up. And then take it all the way back out to the back. Opening the left hip all the way up, left arm comes up, coming into our little variation of Ardha Chandrasana. See if you can take the gaze up to the ceiling. Stay with the breath. And exhale, release. So just knowing that throughout all of our practice today, only do what feels good in your body. If you need to take a little child's pose, for anyone new to yoga, that's this pose right here. You can go there anytime. Tuck under the toes, shift back through the armpits, through the shoulders, and then trying to keep the upper body where it is. So arms and armpits are exactly where they are. Just gonna start to straighten through the legs. But keeping the knees with a little bend in for our first downward facing dog, maybe taking a little pedal out through the feet, one at a time. Maybe a shake of the hips, nod or a shake of the head. So first downward facing dog, the practice, just having a little bit of freedom to do what it is that your body is asking of you. On your inhale, start to walk your feet to the hands. Feet about hip width apart, just let the head hang heavy. Take hold of opposite elbows. And it wouldn't be long till I had to take my top off. I just can't deal with these baggy tops. Take hold of opposite elbows, close off the eyes. Gently swaying side to side. And then coming to find stillness, just shift that weight a little bit further into the ball of the feet. And then bring the bottom all the way down. So you can release the hands, bring the bottom down onto the heels, then coming up onto the toes. So we're in this kind of like squat position up on the toes, bring the hands to heart center. You're gonna push up through the legs using legs and glute, keeping the core nice and steady and strong as we push all the way up to standing. See if you can stay on those toes. And release down, standing into Dasana. We're gonna work through a couple of half sun salutations, some A's and some B's. So just lift up through the toes of the feet. You're gonna pop those toes down one by one, trying not to go into claw hands. Standing nice and steady. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, bend the knees, forward fold. Inhale, create space. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep the arms high. Exhale, release the hands down through heart center. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, find length. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep the arms all the way up. Exhale, hands come down through heart center, Surya Namaskar A. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift the chest, create space. Exhale, place the hands. Let's step back and modify together for this first one. Lowering down to the knees on our exhale, keeping those elbows in as we lower all the way down to the mat. Inhale, take a baby cobra. Take an extra breath here. See if we can take the hands off of the mat. Place those hands down, tuck under the toes, push through the arms, work all the way back, downward facing dog. So really tapping into that breath now, finding a nice strong connection with your Ujjayi breathing. So using every asana practice, every physical practice as a meditation, a moving meditation. Using the breath to guide you from posture to posture, smooth transitions, being mindful. On your next inhale, step the feet to the hands, lift the chest, create space. Exhale, fold down over both legs. Inhale, sweep the arms all the way up to the sky. Exhale, hands through heart center. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift the chest, create space. Exhale, place the hands. Option, step or float back, lowering down either to the knees or down through Chaturanga. Inhaling, upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Again, reconnect with the breath. So let's just bring the mind to the foundations here in our downward facing dog, spreading through the fingers, grounding down through the hands, through the feet. If your heels are off the mat, just take a bend in the knees. And just see if you can work those heels down. The heels don't need to be on the mat. It's just a gesture of where they're heading. And then we want to be spiraling the armpits towards each other. So if that doesn't make much sense for you, think about the eye of the elbow facing each other instead. On your legs, inhale, step or jump, feet to the hands, lift the chest, create space. Exhale, fold down over both legs. Inhale, sweep the arms all the way up. Exhale, hands come down through heart center. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift the chest, create space. Exhale, place the hands, step or jump back, lowering down through Chaturanga or down to the knees. Inhaling, upward facing dog or a cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. From here, let's sweep the right leg up, but keeping a nice square hip. This is one of those postures that feels really weird. Like we're kind of used to being like, oh yeah, I want to open everything. But let's close the hip. Notice how that feels. Push away through the right heel. And then from here, open out through the hip. Stay square in the shoulders, strong in the shoulders. And release that right leg down. Let's go to the left. Again, pushing away with the left heel. Hips are square. Notice how that feels in the body. What I'm really asking is to feel the difference between every little thing that we do. So a closed hip, and then moving into an open hip, keeping those shoulders square, staying strong through the shoulder joint. Exhale, release that left leg down. On your next inhale, come up to the toes. Exhale, bend the knees. Inhale, step or just jump the feet forward. Lift through the chest. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep the arms all the way up. Exhale, hands come down through heart center. Let's move on to some Surya Namaskar B. Sorry, Rob's just got home. Simba's trying to get out. Bear with me. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift the chest, create space. Exhale, place the hands. Step or jump back, lowering down either through the knees or down through Chaturanga. Inhaling, upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. On your inhale, step right foot towards the hands, either a really nice soft transition. So really think about drawing up into the belly, dome through the upper back to get that foot there. If that's not possible and you can only get your foot halfway, take the right hand to the right ankle and just move the foot forwards. Inhale, sweep the arms high. And a nice variation of warrior one is just to pop that heel up. So if that works better for you, go there. Exhale, frame the foot, step it all the way back, work down through your Chaturanga or down to the knees, inhaling upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, step forward, left side, warrior one. So find your variation. We'll just take an extra breath here. Exhaling, frame the foot, step it back, lowering down either to the knees or down through Chaturanga. Inhaling, upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. So from here, just reset with the breath in case you lost it. So the first sun B of a practice is normally the place where we kind of start to fire up the energy within the body. So the tendency is just to lose that connection a little bit to the breath. So just make sure you've got that. On your inhale, step or jump the feet to the hands, lift the chest, create space. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, hinge at the hips, bend the knees, Utkatasana. Exhale, hands through heart center, stand tall. Inhale, Utkatasana. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, find lift, find length. Exhale, place the hands, step or jump back, lowering down either to the knees or down through Chaturanga. Inhaling, upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, step forward, right side, come to find warrior one. Sweep those arms all the way up. Exhale, frame the foot as you come all the way back down through your vinyasa, meeting back in a downward facing dog. Inhale, stepping left side forward, sweep the arms all the way up. Exhale, frame the foot, step it all the way back, lowering down through the knees or down through Chaturanga. Inhaling, upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. So if you're looking to make this a little bit more of a powerful practice, you could come down to a turbo dog. So this is where we're going to take a bend in the elbows and then draw the elbows together, almost like you're halfway between downward facing dog and dolphin. So that's if you're looking to make your practice a little bit harder. Stay there, just because I've come out of it doesn't mean you can, unless you're being kind to your body as you set your intention as. So either staying there or coming down to a child's pose if you need a little rest. Those of you on your turbo dog, don't let the breath stop, don't hold the breath, work with that. Straightening the arms. On it, inhale, step or jump the feet to the hands. Lift the chest, create space. Exhale, fold down over both legs. Inhale, bend the knees, hip knees, hinge at the hips. Utkatasana, holding here. So take that bottom back. You should be able to see the toes. Nice, long, straight spine. Perfect, Simba. And stand tall. Really nice. Just take a little breath. Hands down by the side. Reset. You're going to heel toe those feet outside, to the outside edge of the mat. Toes are facing outwards. You're going to come all the way down to our yogic squat, Malasana. Hands come to heart center. Lift through the chest. Place the left hand down. You can keep the left elbow on the left knee and you can sweep that right arm all the way up. So this left elbow is helping us just find a little bit more openness as we then open through the chest. And then you can place that right hand down. Again, take right elbow to right knee, find that open, and then take the left arm all the way up. And release that left hand down. Okay, from here, you're gonna lift up the bottom. We're gonna come to Arbakasana, crow pose. Just because somebody said at the start that they've just learned how to do it, so it's a nice time to practice. Now, if you know that crow pose is totally out of your range, out of your limits for today, then you're just gonna stay in Malasana or yogic squat. I'm gonna show you another way that you can work on it if you're not quite there yet, but you wanna give it a go. So we're gonna really spread through the fingers, through the hands. You're gonna lift the bottom up. Take a bend in the elbows. The elbows, the arms are working as a shelf for the knees. You're then gonna work with counterbalance. If it helps, you can put a cushion in front of you, maybe when you've got a little bit more time to work on it, just in case you're worried about the face plant. And then all you're gonna do is just work your way forwards and come back. You don't even need to take the feet off. Maybe you could try taking one foot off, and then the other. If you have your crow or your crane, depending on where you're going, you're gonna hold and then you're gonna shoot the legs back, which is not what I'm gonna do. Simba, I'm gonna have to ask you to move, thank you. And then we're all gonna work our way down through a vinyasa, inhaling upward facing dog or cobra, exhale downward facing dog. Okay, sweeping that right leg all the way up, opening through the hips, bending the right knee. Either staying here or taking that right foot all the way over, coming to find a wild thing. So arm is up over by the head. From here, we're gonna exhale as we bend to the knees and bend the arm. Inhale, take it back. Exhale. Inhale. Last time, exhale. Inhale. Bring it all the way back around to your three-leg dog. Release that right foot, bring it through. So you're in plank, right knee to nose. Place the right foot down. So left hand is next to the right foot. You're gonna open out right hand all the way up to the ceiling. If this is too much, just come down to that back knee. So really nice modification, still working on the twist, still working into the hips. Bringing that right arm all the way over. Take the right hand to the inside of the right foot, heel toe that right foot out. Drop the back knee down, coming to a little hip opening, a little bit of lizard, so either staying up in the chest. You can come down to the forearms if that feels good. Maybe if you're kind of in that halfway between point, take your block and just pop your forearms on your block. See, you've always got options. From here, maybe taking that right hand to the right knee, opening the heart all the way out, all the way up even. And release all the way back. So, down on your elbow or up on the left hand. Tuck under the left foot, pick up the left knee. You're then gonna pivot on that back foot. Come to find Vashistasana, our side plank. So you can do this now on the elbow. If this is way too intense, you can even drop that left knee down and just keep it super simple. Those of you wanting to go even further in your Vashistasana, you're gonna come from here. We're either gonna take it to tree or you're gonna take the two peace fingers around the big toe, opening all the way out. Breathing, hold one more breath. When you're ready, coming all the way back over into a high plank, lowering down either to the knees or down to your Chaturanga, inhaling upward facing dog or cobra, exhale downward facing dog. Reset, take a child's pose if you need it. From here, let's sweep that left leg high, opening the hips, strong in the shoulders. I like a pointed toe in my open hip three-leg dog. Just kind of makes me feel like the energy is really traveling as high as possible. You could bend that knee. And then either staying here or taking the left foot all the way over, being careful not to stand on a dog, and coming to find your wild thing, left arm goes by the face. On an exhale, bend the knees, bend the arms. Inhale, take it back up. Exhale, bend the arms, and the knees even. Inhale, take it back. Last time, exhale. Inhale. Pivot all the way back around, three-leg dog. Bring that left knee to nose as you come forward to your high plank. Quietly, silently transition the left foot forward, keep the right hand down next to the left foot. Sweep that left arm high up to the sky. Option of dropping the right knee down. Taking the gaze up to that left hand. Okay, slowly bring the left hand down. Place it on the inside of the left foot. Heel toe the left foot out, drop the right knee down. Option again, staying up on the hands, this might be enough for you. Coming down to the forearms or just taking that block as a little bit of a midway through. So maybe even finding a little bit of movement here. And then maybe opening out to the left side, taking the left hand to the knee, gazing up to the sky. Holding here. and slowly bringing left hand back down. Okay, so either staying down on the elbow for a modified Vajrasasana or coming up onto the hands, tuck under right foot, lift up through the right knee, transition over onto that pivoted foot, maybe stacking the feet, maybe taking hold of the toes, maybe just dropping this right knee down. There are so many variations for you to find the flow that works for you. Be breathing wherever you are. So if you're stacking, lifting those hips as high as they'll go, gazing up to the sky. One more big breath here. And then bring it all the way around, lowering down to the knees or coming down through Chaturanga, lifting through the chest. Exhale, downward facing dog. And reconnect to the breath. Okay, you've got a little couple of options here. So either coming down to a child's pose or coming down to a dolphin. So you're coming down to a dolphin, you're gonna do it by squeezing the elbows together, either dropping one elbow down at a time or bringing both elbows down together. If you're in your dolphin, you're gonna walk those feet in as far as they'll go. Push out through the shoulders. So we don't want the head collapsing down to the mat. You wanna push out through the shoulders. Maybe you wanna take one leg up at a time, come up to the toes, see how that feels. Try not just like throwing yourself up into a pincher. The tendency is that we kind of love being upside down and we want to get upside down as quick as possible. But literally just by doing dolphin and picking up one leg at a time, you're going to get a lot stronger, quicker for your dolphin, for your pincher, sorry, rather than just sort of throwing yourself up. But by all means, if you have pincher Mahirasana in your practice and you want to take one now, try and go for it. Don't go over like I've just done, onto a block. Okay, so wherever you are, coming down to the knees. If you're still in your child's pose, you can stay where you are. You're gonna interlace the hands behind the back. Draw the arms down by the bottom, lift through the chest, opening through the shoulders. And then you're gonna take a round in the spine, drop the head. Place the hands down, tuck under the toes, come back to a downward facing dog. You're either gonna jump through to a seated position or you're gonna walk your feet all the way through using the core. Coming down to Paschimottanasana. So if you know that you have slightly tighter hamstrings, you're living in a slightly tighter body, grab yourself a block and you can pop it underneath the bottom. So flexing through the feet, inhale, draw tall through the torso. Exhale, hinging at the hips. If you have a strap, it's really great to use in postures like this because it allows us to keep the spine straight as we work the body forwards. On an inhale, just ease off, lift through the chest. Exhale, forward fold. Maybe even closing off the eyes, taking the gaze inwards. On your inhale, start to lift the chest all the way up. You're gonna bring this right knee into the chest. We're gonna take a little twist. So right hand comes behind you, right knee is into the chest, left foot is flexed. Inhale, left arm reaches all the way up. Exhale, either hug the knee or you can take that left elbow over the knee. If you find that when you do this, your shoulders are like this, then there's no point in being there. Just hug the knee and open that way. Connecting. Exhale, release. Just let that right knee drop out to the side, opening through the hips. Keep the right hand behind the bottom. Inhale, sweep the left arm all the way up. Pushing the hips and the heart to the sky. And And then place the hands down, probably to the back of your mat now. And you're going to push up on that left foot and bring the right knee around for a right side pigeon. So it's possible that you're now not facing wherever you have me in your room. But you can hear my voice. Just trust that you know what you're doing. If you need a block underneath the right side glute, then that's fine. Inhale, find a little bit of length. So a nice self-assist here is to take the right hand to the right thigh, open that right thigh out, and the left hand to the left hip, and then you're pivoting that left hip forward. So we're working on squaring the hips here. And then taking a forward fold if that feels good, and you want to close the eyes. And inhale, just kind of ease off the stretch a little bit, and then exhale as you elongate through the torso to come a little bit deeper. Inhale, lifting all the way up. You're just going to sit back onto that right side glute and ever so gracefully swing yourself all the way around back to face the front of the mat. Bringing the left knee in this time. Okay, so left hand goes behind you, flexing through the right foot. Inhale, right arm sweeps high. Exhale as you take the twist, either with the hug of the knee or taking the elbow all the way over the top of the knee. Remembering that you want to stay as open as possible in those shoulders. So the stretch is coming through the torso and we're opening through the chest. Staying with that breath. And then bringing it all the way back around to center. Just drop open that left knee. So you're open through the hips. Right, left hand goes behind the bottom. Sweep the right arm all the way up. Push the hips and the heart up to the sky. Expression of postures like this. I love this and wild thing. Just really taking back to like my dancing days, finding the expression. Okay, take the hands behind you. So going back to the back of the mat, bring that left knee around for left side pigeon. Again, taking any blocks or props that you need. And then taking that self-assist. So right hand to the left, sorry, left hand to the left thigh. Apparently my left and right are slightly confused today. And right hand onto the right hip. When you're ready, take an inhale and then exhale as you work the body forwards. Maybe just closing off the eyes, taking the gaze inwards. Taking an inhale, finding a bit more length as you exhale, coming a little bit deeper. Inhaling, lift the chest all the way up. Sit onto that left side bottom and swing those legs around ever so gracefully to the front of the mat. Okay. Placing the hands about a hand's distance behind you, keeping the knees bent in, knees about hip width apart, just firing up that core again, because a flow with me would not be a flow without some core work. On an inhale, we're gonna push the hips up to the sky. And then as you exhale, keeping the bottom off the mat, you're gonna bring the feet back onto the heels and the bottom swings through the hands. Inhale, lift hips to the sky. Exhale, bottom comes through. Inhale, lift. Exhale, bottom comes through. Keep it lifted. And last one, inhale, lift that bottom. Exhale, bring it all the way through the hands and release. Just give the hands a little bit of a shake out. That one can be quite intense on the wrists. Bringing the knees up now for Navasana, boat pose. So options here are just to keep the toes down, hands behind the knees, lift the chest, or you can rock back a little bit, lift those knees, arms come by the side. If you're feeling super sassy, you can straighten the legs and you can take those arms high. But if you notice that the back ends up doing like this, then there's no point. Just bring yourself back to here and work on the strength this way. When you're ready, cross right over left. Swing the hips through, hands come down. Shoot the feet back or step them back. Work down through a vinyasa. Inhaling, upward facing dog or cobra. And we'll meet back in our downward facing dog. On an inhale, start to walk those feet or jump the feet through to the hands. Bottom comes down. We're going to come to Baddha Konasana. So soles of the feet are together. And the feet are as close to the hips as you can get them. Take the hands onto the feet. Open those feet out. Lift through the chest. So keeping a nice straight spine. Rather than rounding the back, you're going to keep nice and straight as you then lower down. Basically, my head is in Simba's bum right now. I'm just not going to go so far. I'm just going to hang out here. Closing off the eyes. Connecting to the breath. On an inhale, lifting the chest all the way up. Bringing those feet a little bit further away from you, making a slightly bigger diamond in the legs. Now this time you can round the spine. Inhale, lift. Exhale, you want to draw the forehead or the crown of the head down towards that little gap in the feet. It's not going to necessarily go there, but that's kind of where it's heading. Again, closing off the eyes. On an inhale, coming all the way up. We're going to come to our final Navasana. So bringing yourself into boat pose. I'm going to take some toe taps. So dropping the right foot down to begin with. So we're going right. One, left, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Hold. Cross left over right this time. Shoot those feet back. Come down through your vinyasa, whichever variation or modification you need to take. Meeting back in our downward facing dog. Okay, dropping down to the knees. So I'm going to give you a little yogi's choice. It's International Yoga Day. So to finish off, you can either, if you have a strong headstand and you're at home and you want to take a little headstand, by all means, go for that. If you would like to take a shoulder stand, go for that. If you're feeling like, you know what, I've had a really long day, can't, and I just want to chill out, you're going to take the block underneath you, pop your bottom up onto the block, take the body back, lift the legs up, palms facing upwards. It's a really nice restorative inversion with the hips above the heart. So whichever it is you're going for, just spend a minute or two working through that. If you're kind of wanting to work on headstand, I'll just talk you through the setup. So we'll take hold of opposite elbows. Elbows come down to the mat. The elbows stay exactly where they are. They just work as a pivot for the hands. Interlace the hands. Place those hands down in front of you. Now, the hairline of the head
comes down towards the mat. As you tuck under the toes and lift the knees, the hips are going to go up, which is then going to send a little bit more of the head into the hands. From here, you can just see what it feels like to take one leg up, bring it down, the other leg up, bring it down, maybe come down to a child's pose. If you want to take some lifts, if you have quite a strong headstand, why not work on a few core lifts, just tapping the feet down and lifting them back up again. So whichever variation you're taking, I'm going to give you a moment to do that. If you are going to a shoulder stand, did I give you that as an option? Yes, I did. If you're going to a shoulder stand, please make sure you go to fish pose as your counter pose. If you're doing a headstand, please come down to a child's pose as your counter pose. So I'm going to get down in my child's pose, ready for you all to meet me. You can have another couple of tries in whatever it is that you are finishing with today. Those of us that are just ready for a child's pose, come to a narrow leg variation. So forehead is melting down onto the mat. And then if you've got time, which I'm pretty sure lots of you will have, just come down to a shavasana rather than running off. Most important part of the practice, our shavasana. Either legs out long or you could bend up the knees, let the knees drop together, palms of the hands facing upwards, close off the eyes. Give the body a little bit of time to reset. Sometimes we're so hectic with life and the asana practice, we forget about the most important part, which is just resetting, taking a moment to tap into the body and scan the body. So keeping those eyes closed, just working your way all the way from the tips of the toes all the way up to the crown of the head, just asking each section of the body to relax. Seeing how it feels as you lay there, noticing the body just melt down, the breath start to soften. Then you can stay in your shavasana for longer if you wish. If not, you're going to roll over to one side and slowly make your way up to a comfortable seated position. Just take your time, no rush. When you get to your comfortable seated position, keep the eyes closed, hands come to heart center. We'll seal our practice with one round of Om. I invite you to join me. Inhale. Let's just take a moment to be grateful for this practice. So yoga has evolved in many weird and wonderful ways since it was first spoken about thousands of years ago, and it's just pretty awesome that we have this movement and this philosophy that we can look into and live our lives by. And if maybe you're somebody that has only ever done yoga for the physical, maybe it's time to start looking at it in other ways, because it's a really beautiful practice. Yoga is a way of living your life, not just a practice on a mat. So I leave you with that thought and gratitude. Thank you all so much for flowing with me. Namaste.
Thank you. We did it. Thank you so, so much. I'm going to come towards the camera now so that I can just let me know if you enjoyed it. That would always be nice. I think Rob is like desperate for us to have some dinner, so I'm not going to stay chatting for too long. I'm going to do this like weird sassy crawl over to the, over to the thingy. Hi. Okay, so I am going to love you and leave you. Thank you so, so much for practicing with me. And I hope to see you again soon. This flow will stay here, by the way.